see if we can get this in one take. Good morning, everybody. This is Ned over at My Philippine Dreams here in Dumaguete City. I hope everybody enjoyed the last three videos I put up. It was from a December trip I took down to the city of Dipolog, down in northwestern Mindanao. It's a beautiful place for sunsets and mango shakes and the occasional serenade. I enjoy doing travel videos. They don't get a whole lot of views. They only get like 3,000, 4,000 views. And they actually require a lot of work, a lot of editing, a lot of setup, composition, all that. But when it comes down to it, basically I'm not doing YouTube for the money. I'm actually doing it for the vanity, as Tom S. noted. Shout out to Tom S. All right, this is going to be a short video, hopefully, regarding a comment I received about a week ago on a video I published back in 2014. I'll put up the link to that video down in the video description box so you can check it out. This is actually from a five-year-old video. And this gentleman, his anonymous YouTube username is The Jockman. Jockman is with an H, J-H-O-C-K-M-A-N. And Mr. Jockman starts with, I dated a girl once from Dumaguete, and she scammed me out of what turned to luckily not be a huge amount of money. Sorry to hear that. Later, I found out that she was already engaged to another American while she was with me. Hey, we've all been there. I've been with my present fiancé now for about a year. She is from Cagayan de Oro. Cagayan de Oro is down in Mindanao, the north central section of it, Misamis Occidental. From my understanding, there are Muslims in CDO. However, she tells me that she is not in an area that is really that bad. All right, I'm kind of paraphrasing some of the things he's saying because it's kind of disjointed. All right, so as far as I can tell, about 6 to 11% of the Filipino population is Muslim. On hard figures provided from the Philippines authorities has it lowballed at about 6%. U.S. State Department has it at about 11%, with about 10 million Filipinos being of Muslim faith. They are scattered all over the Philippines, but concentrated in certain areas down in the southwest section of the nation. Dumaguete is like in the Visayas. We're kind of north of Mindanao, northeast of all that. But we actually got our own mosque. I think Dumaguete actually has two mosques here. So Muslims are all over the place. They're everywhere. They're ubiquitous. Jockman goes on to say, she says they are mainly in the province, mountain areas, and even when they do start attacking the city, it's only in certain areas and certain times of the year. All right, I thought that statement was kind of weird. It's like, what are they, on a seasonal schedule? I mean, when you're saying something like that, you're kind of answering your own question. Jockman continues, I will be moving to the Philippines before the end of the year. I have discussed moving out of Mindanao with her, maybe to Cebu or Anhalay City. Okay, as far as Cebu and Angeles goes, I would definitely check those cities out before you actually decide to move there. Myself, personally, I really could not live in a really, really big city or a big congested area like Cebu or Angeles. And there's all kinds of other islands all across the Philippines and cities and stuff. You need to travel around and check it out. Jockman continues. She seems fine with it, but also throws in hints of wanting to stay in CDO, such as when she will give me prices of homes for rent and apartments for rent in Cagayan de Oro. What is your guys' opinion and advice on the matter? I love Cagayan de Oro. It's a beautiful place. The only thing negative I've seen there was when the Muslims attacked the city during the St. Augustine Festival. However, it was nowhere near to her that it was happening. It was on the opposite side of the city. Would CDO be safe enough as an expat for me to live, or should I continue to suggest moving to another island? There are a lot of expats living in our city that have never had a problem at all. All right, I wasn't able to find anything on the St. Augustine Festival attack in CDO, but I did notice that since 1993, 13 people have been killed and over 100 have been injured in terrorist attacks in Misamis Occidental. And that's the province that CDO, again, is located in. Again, I recommend that you travel around to different places, travel light, spend a week here, a week there, and check them out. Take your time and basically don't rush it. And getting towards the end, Mr. Jockman wraps it up by saying, as for managing to survive monetarily in the Philippines, I have already got that all in line. He's got it all figured out. My fiancé is investing in a piggery for me there so that we will have a steady stream of income when I get there. It seems to be a great investment. The investment in piggery is bringing in 3/4 of the initial investment every month. A 10,000 peso investment started bringing back about 7,000 pesos monthly, and then 40,000 peso investment started bringing about 30,000 pesos monthly. I am about to invest some more and start the preparations for my move there. Any advice from you guys? Love the channel. Yeah, I'm sure everybody right now who's watching this video is like sitting on the edge of their seat screaming into their monitors. First up, I don't know how well you know this woman, but if you're sending this amount of money to her and she's saying she's making so much money off of these piggeries, take it with a grain of salt. I'm just saying. And piggeries, you know, don't count your piglets if she indeed does have this piggery going. Don't count your piglets before they hatch. If you're already really making that much money, congratulations. A 75% profit on your initial investment is pretty dang impressive. Unfortunately, I have known a number of gentlemen who have got themselves involved with piggeries, and just about every single one of them except for two, and I'd say about 80% then, because I know about 10 guys with piggeries, actually listed the names out, have basically, the businesses have failed for a variety of reasons. And there's actually another Philippines vlogger who's actually now in Vietnam who had a piggery for a little while, and he found out that it didn't work because you're having to trust other people. They're killing the pigs, they're lying, there's all kinds of crazy stuff going on. In short, it seems to be a whole lot of hogwash. And also, think about the stench that these our little poor kind friends create. The stinkiest thing I've ever experienced is the smell of a piggery. Actually, no, death's worse than that. A decomposing body is actually worse than a piggery, but piggery runs definitely a close second. As for other advice, and that's, again, this is for anybody, and I'm not an expert on the Philippines. I've been here about 5.5 years, and I still haven't started to even begin to figure it out. Above all else, take your time. Don't rush into things. Think things through. Experience it. You know, get here and decide if you actually want to stay here. Don't count on Philippines-based income at first to take care of your financial needs. You need a good savings amount of savings before you come here, and you need a steady income from somewhere. Also, travel around and look for some place that you would actually want to live for a long time. Again, the Philippines is huge. There's all kinds of cities all over the place. Travel light, travel around, take your time, maybe take a girl with you, zip around, see if this is where you'd like to stay or that is where you'd like to stay, and don't rush into things. Next up, rent. Don't buy. Rent in the Philippines is incredibly cheap. Construction costs are actually increasing exponentially. I've actually talked to a guy who does a lot of building here on Negros, and he's been talking about how the construction costs have been increasing a lot over the past 2 or 3 years. Also, don't invest any serious amount of money into anything for at least a year or two. There's a big difference between just visiting the Philippines and living here long term. It's basically apples and oranges, or you might even want to go as far as to say it's basically like ampalayas and oranges. It's a big difference. And keep in mind that the vast majority of foreigners actually can't live here long term or decide not to live here long term. They'll stay here for 2, 3, 4, 5 years. And then decide, hey, you know what, this ain't for me, and they're out. And finally, have an exit plan. I mean, you gotta have, if things don't turn right, or if everything goes south, or if the pigs turn feral and try to kill you, or whatever, you gotta have a contingency plan for getting yourself out of the Philippines, going back to the US or the UK or whatever, and starting up again. Because a lot of guys get into this, I'm selling everything and moving to the Philippines, and they haven't lived here long term, which is not recommended, even though I did it. But again, I'm the ultimate hypocrite. So make sure you have that exit plan. If things don't work out here, what are you going to do? And as far as doing that, what are you going to do? You got to have the financial means to be able to do that. All right, so that's basically this video in a nutshell. Leave your comments down in the comment section. If you have any advice for Mr. Jockman, please leave it down there. And until next time, this is Ned over my Philippine dreams. Take care, everybody. Careful with the piggeries. And now for something completely different.
That was an encore presentation. exclusively on My Philippine Dreams. Thanks to all our backup singers. Thank you very much. Salamat kaayo. Salamat sa imang tabang. Adios. Nice job. No comments from the peanut gallery. Oy, jeez. Hey, if you consider our work to be of any value, consider supporting us on Patreon. If you're a Patreon, you get a free copy of my ebook, and we do monthly Google Hangouts. So consider doing that, if you would please.